Hey there! Do you have a fantastic idea for a fitness website or app like MyFitnessPal or Nike Training Club? Or maybe you want to create something completely unique by combining activity tracking with a workout marketplace for HIIT workouts, gym trainings, diet tracking, meditation, and more? Well, I have some great news for you. In this YouTube video, I'll guide you through the step-by-step process of developing your software, pricing it correctly, avoiding common mistakes, and sharing some pro tips to ensure your app is profitable right from the start. My name is Dennis Babich, and I'm the director of a software development company. I'm excited to share valuable insights not only from my team, but also from industry experts and successful startup owners. If you're ready to bring your idea to life, let's get started. Designing a fitness app website comes with many advantages. By developing your own fitness app, you have the opportunity to combine various fitness app niches to create your unique, innovative software product. Currently, the market offers diet tracking apps, activity tracking apps, and workout apps. You can take some of the ideas from these apps and integrate them with, for example, a video streaming marketplace, just like Spotify, but for fitnesses. Why not? Let's say users can subscribe to your platform for only 10 bucks per month and gain access to numerous contents and unique features. You're a smart entrepreneur if you're already watching this video, and you can outplay competitors easily. Just follow the methodology that I will share. Great, let's start by identifying the key components and features that are vital for a successful fitness website or app. For example, our fitness marketplace app includes mobile applications for both iOS and Android platforms, a web application, and a web-based admin zone. The mobile app offers a number of features, including authorization, creating tailored workout programs, Apple Watch compatibility, results tracking, sharing results with friends, and more. The web application will have almost the same features as the mobile app, with the addition of advanced functionalities, such as subscribing to the service, selecting music for workouts, and adding a coach's voice for motivation during your workout routine. The web-based admin zone provides numerous functions to manage your users, content, analytics, security settings, payment issues, video management, and user support. When developing a fitness app website or marketplace, it's crucial to concentrate on creating a minimum viable product, MVP first. Fitness platforms are typically complex and require a significant amount of time and effort to develop and improve user experience. To accomplish this, it's vital to focus on one unique feature and the standard 4-5 functions that are necessary for your app to operate quickly. For instance, if you're designing a fitness subscription platform, concentrate on one unique features, such as customized workout modifications by users, and standard functions like login, subscription, profile, and video list. The key to success is to implement one unique feature at a time, allowing for a winning strategy. Speed is critical at this stage, since a large user base will attract angel investors or acquisition offers from big companies. In this market, competition isn't an issue, as there are numerous successful fitness apps, making it a huge market with plenty of room for unique ideas, especially if you combine different parts of different markets. The crucial point is to focus on unique positioning and fast execution from the MVP stage 1 to MVP stage 2 and beyond. Your goal is to learn the methodology I will share and take your first baby steps today. Alright, let's discuss the pricing aspect of building a fitness app, website, or marketplace. Determining the price can be tricky, as there are often overlooked factors such as quality assurance, bug fixing, project management, maintenance, and risk management. To keep things simple, I will provide with you pricing only for the core MVP functionality. One tip to keep in mind is that if you need an in-house development team due to an investor contract, you can expect to pay US or EU prices. However, outsourcing software development to Ukraine can be the best value for money. Many successful startups such as GitLab, Grammarly, and Jubal have recognized the value of hiring Ukrainian developers to create top-notch software. Ukrainian developers are known for their excellent English skills, extensive outsourcing development experience, innovative thinking, and strong work ethic. Now that you have an idea of pricing, you may be wondering which features to include in your MVP and which to skip. The key factor is your understanding of the market and how the features are interconnected within your app. Your expertise can determine your success or failure. In the next session, I will teach you how to identify essential features and avoid potential financial fails. After conducting extensive research on various YouTube channels and web guides, I couldn't find any valuable information on how to start your first business without prior software app development experience. That's why I've created the ultimate 10-step guide to help you take the right steps towards app success. Skipping any of these steps could lead to a waste of your time and money. It's crucial to note that the costs of app development can vary significantly, ranging from $30,000 to $100,000. Therefore, it's important to carefully consider the cost differences between each type of app to identify which option provides the best return on investment for your specific goals and needs at this stage. Let's explore how to pinpoint the key functionalities of your fitness application. To begin, the initial step is to generate a lean canvas business strategy to assist you in identifying your core characteristics and your unique selling points. Start by identifying your target audience and assessing what features they require that aren't presented accessible on platforms such as MyFitnessPal or Nike Training Club. Additionally, investigate your rivals or other solutions that may address the issues of your target audience. Evaluate your unfair advantage, the aspect that distinguishes you from the competition and enhances your likelihood of success. Perhaps you have a community of workout enthusiasts on YouTube that you may bring to your new app, lowering your user acquisition expenses. Then identify your early adopters and the online locations where they spend their time and create strategies to encourage them to use your platform. However, don't simply concentrate on the present. Plan for the future and keep in mind the possibility of international expansion for your fitness app. Having a long-term vision for your app's growth in 5 or 10 years is crucial for attracting investors and achieving unicorn status. If you have any questions, concepts, or concerns, feel free to share them in the comment section below. I personally review all comments and I'm delighted to assist you in achieving your objectives. Additionally, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you. Achieving product market fit is an essential milestone for establishing a profitable and successful startup. This involves providing innovative and disruptive solutions that meet the needs of your target audience. To achieve this, completing your value proposition table is crucial. Let's assume you have a distinctive concept for a global fitness subscription marketplace platform, similar to Spotify. The initial step is to identify the primary pains and gains of your target audience, such as difficulty starting workouts for beginners, lack of motivation, expensive workout courses, confusion about which course to select, confusion about what to do for professionals, and difficulty modifying workouts to suit individual needs. Your platform should offer solutions to these issues, such as motivational features that showcase your progress once you start a workout program, sharing results with friends, competitive capabilities, a subscription-based model, a list of courses for beginners and advanced users, a personalized system for creating workout plans, and a modification system that allows for the selection of music, exercise lengths, countdown, and motivational speeches from a coach. When using the value proposition canvas, prioritize delivering significant value to your audience. Remember, smaller companies can outcompete industry leaders by being agile, adaptable, and fast by investing their attention to unique niches. Make sure that with this knowledge, you take your first business steps today, because the one who enters the game first is the only one who wins. In detail researching your competitions and analyzing their key features and functionalities, it's essential to create a successful app. It's highly recommended to focus on industry leaders such as MyFitnessPal or Nike Training Club and adopt their successful user flows, proven functionalities, features, and concepts. It's not necessary to reinvent the wheel. However, it's also essential to explore successful fitness startups in other countries and local niches and adopt their ideas to your market to gain a competitive advantage while creating a unique product that stands out in your market. If you're planning to develop a fitness app or business and still have knowledge gaps, don't hesitate to contact me through any of the links in the description. I'm here to help and would be happy to share some niche insights that could be a game changer for your startup. To build a successful minimum viable product for your app, it's important to correctly select the most essential features and prioritize functionalities that can be developed and launched really quickly. The great method to accomplish this is by creating a story map, which focuses on the limited but most critical features and functionality. To ensure that all user needs are met, it's vital to develop a separate story map for each user type. By doing so, you have to identify the features that are most important for each user and prioritize them accordingly, ensuring that your MVP meets your user needs and provides the maximum value with minimum functionality. Marketing your fitness app can be simplified by identifying small content creators who focus on specific fitness problems, such as HIIT workouts, meal tracking, or meditation. These creators tend to have a real followers, and you can offer incentives to promote your app. Search for them on social media platforms like Instagram, TikTok, or YouTube. It's recommended to avoid big channels with millions of subscribers, as you may not know if their users are real, and at the initial stages, it's essential to allocate your resources wisely. Once you have 5 to 10 niche content creators promoting your app and attracting your initial customers, they will help spread the word about your app in their communities. This can increase your app's user base and build a solid reputation in the market. If you're interested in gaining more valuable insights on startups and businesses and want to become a part of a community of business founders, click the link in the video description and join my Discord channel. As a member, you will have access to useful information and engage in live chats. Once you have finished your research on the value proposition and identified the essential features for your MVP, the next step is to create a wireframe map. This will assist you in arranging your concepts and ensuring that all user cases and scenarios are covered. Let's take our fitness subscription platform as an example. It could include basic use cases such as logging in, creating tailored workout, payment, and so on. Missing use cases such as what should happen if the coach forgot to add music to their workout. Designing a user interface, UI, is a crucial part of the app development process, but it doesn't have to be complex. If you look at major platforms such as MyFitnessPal or Nike Training Club, you will notice that they have simple design that prioritizes the video courses or meal tracking feature. This functionality is often considered the most valuable feature of fitness apps. That's why you should focus on creating a clean and straightforward design that emphasizes your list of short videos and your unique customization feature without any unnecessary distractions. Pro tip: if you need inspiration for your design, check out portfolios on websites like Behance or Dribbble. Look for fitness apps and incorporate design elements that catch your eye. If you found these tips helpful, please consider subscribing to my channel and liking this video. Your support will help increase its visibility in the YouTube algorithm. Thank you. Choosing the right technology stack is critical for success of your software development project, as it ensures that your app remains relevant to your users' evolving needs. On the other hand, choosing the wrong tech stack can lead to issues like slow user interfaces, non-scalable and non-maintainable cloud infrastructure, high costs, payment and subscription problems, and the risk of your app going offline during traffic spikes. If you're creating a fitness subscription platform, it's crucial to choose the appropriate tech stack to develop your minimum viable product quickly. Flutter or React Native are excellent options for rapidly building mobile apps, while Python, Django, Node.js, and Amazon Web Services are ideal for backend development. Web applications can be easily built using React, Vue.js, and Angular. Additionally, you can speed up your development process by using third-party services like Stripe and Braintree for payment processing, Twilio for SMS, and SendGrid for emails. However, if you plan to include live video streaming with coaches in your app, it's better to use native languages like Swift for iOS and Kotlin for Android. Flutter and React Native may not be able to handle these issues correctly. It's crucial to choose the appropriate tech stack for each phase of your software development process, starting with a minimum viable product, but planning ahead based on your future feature set when designing your app architecture. Choosing the right tech stack is crucial for your app success, just like receiving the correct diagnosis after a blood test. Let's talk about Agile process, a highly effective methodology that can speed up your development and increase efficiency. However, it's important to note that in some cases, it may slow down project progress by up to 30%. For example, a team of 5 developers who work well together, communicate effectively, and have done the code of the project's core features and architecture can use simple tools like Trello, Asana, Google Docs, and brief meetings to have a highly effective progress. But when the team grows to 15 or more members, there may be unexpected issues, including losing key developers from the team, complex and time-consuming onboarding processes, decreasing team productivity, more frequent communication issues, missed deadlines and delivery dates, deteriorating code quality and architecture. To avoid these problems, consider hiring a tech lead to oversee the team and code architecture, employing a technical project manager, implementing processes such as Scrum, Sprints, Backlog, and Retrospective, conducting daily stand-ups and providing updates on pending tasks, utilizing more advanced tools like Jira for management and velocity. Selecting the appropriate tools at the right time can help you achieve your minimum viable product more quickly. However, using the same tools without deep knowledge and expertise can result in failure. Collecting user analytics is crucial to ensure the success of your app. It's essential to understand metrics like unique visitors, user behavior, and frequent sessions. You can use tools like Google Analytics, Session Stack, Firebase, and Mixpanel to gather valuable insights. Regularly performing health checks on your app can also uncover hidden client needs and highlight areas where your app can be improved. By keeping track of user metrics, you can make data-driven decisions to improve your app's performance, enhance user engagement, and increase your chances of success. Alright, if you're planning to create a fitness web or mobile app, but still have some missing pieces of the puzzle, feel free to shoot me a message via Calendly, and we can have a 30-minute call. I would be happy to share some niche insights and my expertise with you that can be a real game changer for your startup. See ya!